Good morning everyone, welcome to the lecture of Water Resource Engineering. In today's lecture we are going to study about the drought and drought management. So today we are going to start this new chapter, unit number 8, drought management and water harvesting. So what is drought? Drought is an extended period of a month or a year when a region notes a deficiency in its water supply, whether surface or underground water supply. So generally this occurs when a region receives continuously below average precipitation, right? जब continuously जो बारिश होती है वो कम होती है तो ऐसी condition में drought की condition आती है. So it can have a substantial impact on economical system and agriculture of affected region. Although droughts can persist for several years, even a short and intense drought can cause a significant damage and harm to the local economy, right? So let's start this new chapter, drought. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the introduction of drought, causes of drought, types of drought, history of drought, effects of drought, and mitigation of a drought. So, look at the pictures and think, what do you observe? So, this global phenomena has a widespread impact on agricultural. Lengthy period of a drought have been longer a key tickets for a mass mitigation and played a key role in a number of ongoing mitigations and other humanitarian. So basically drought is a stable, incidentious and natural hazard that is a normal part of a climate of virtually all the region of the world, and it occurs and results in a myriad of economic, social and environmental impacts in a developed as well as developing nations. So you can see in the figure again. So basically drought is a condition of a water deficit sufficient to have an adverse effect on vegetations, animals and men over a sizable area. So basically a lake or a shortage of a water for an usually long period of a time involving a 50% less than the usual rainfall over a 3 months, right? The land is a barren and covered in thin dust. Cracks appears in earth and this is drought. So what do you mean by drought? The word drought instantly brings an image of a dry and parched land. No rainfall, crop failures, starvation and bad living conditions to our mind. In a simple terms, drought is a condition of an acute scarcity of water, food, fodder and employment due to scanty rainfall in the area. So basically drought is a condition of a water deficient and sufficient to have an adverse effect on a vegetation, animal and man over a area. So are we all vulnerable to drought? Yes, it is one of the most widespread disasters that India faces, affecting more than 70% of cultivable land. Often people do not react to drought like they do to other disasters such as earthquake, cyclone and floods. Since drought conditions develop over a period of time and without immediately perceptible changes to environment, hence the drought is called a slow onset disaster. probability of occurrence of a drought and drought prone areas. So you can see in a pink that there is a probability of occurrence drought more than 20%. That is a chronically drought prone area. You can see in this figure the pink portion. The yellow portion shows a possibility of occurrence of a drought 10 to 20%, and the green area shows probability of occurrence of drought less than 10%. That means least drought prone area. How a drought start? A drought start when a total rainfall is below average for several months. And other signs of a drought includes a very dry soil, trees having a sign of drying, water getting hotter and hotter. You can see in the figure, very dry soil is there. You can see there are some cracks in a soil portion. Now we'll see causes of droughts. So basically, the various causes of droughts are there. The first one is the amount of a water vapor in the atmosphere. So amount of vapor in the atmosphere is the most important cause of a drought, as it creates a precipitation. So more rain, sleet, hail and snow can occur when there is a moist, low pressure in a system. If there is above average presence of dry, high pressure air system, instead, a less moisture is available to produce a precipitation, because a dry and high pressure air system cannot hold as much water vapor, right? अगर atmosphere vapor ही नहीं होगा, तो वहाँ पे precipitation नहीं हो पाएगा. The second one is a shifting of air masses. When winds shift the air masses and warm dry, continental air moves over an area and opposed to cooler and moist oceanic air masses, the area suffered a drought, right? Third, cold and warm water ocean currents. Unusual currents of a cold and warm water in an ocean can also create high pressure system in the Pacific Ocean, and a warm water current known as a El Nino that brings a low pressure system that causes hurricanes and other violent storms to North America. On the other hand, the cold water current known as a La Nina brings a drought in Asia. The opposite occurs with the El Nino, bringing drought, and the reverser airflow causes drought in India. So cold and warm current water also affects the situation of drought. And the next one is the mountains. So higher mountains ranges near the ocean are also responsible for a drought on a leeward side of a mountains. So moisture loaded with the wind blowing from an ocean surfaces to land, strike the barriers like a mountain and rises up, become colder and vapor condense into a rain on a windward side. When the air masses passes over the mountain, it has lost much of its vapor and hence leeward side gets a very less rainfall. Obviously, माउंटेन की वजह से जो सी के ऊपर से जे जो वाटर वाटर के लिए जो हाई प्रेशर सिस्टम होती है वो पास होती है ओशियन टू अदर सरफेसेस, राइट, मॉइस्चर कंटेंट. तो वो जो ये बैरियर्स होते हैं, जैसे कि माउंटेन है या फिर राइज हाई राइज बिल्डिंग्स होते हैं, तो उसकी वजह से क्या होता है कि माउंटेन के ऑपोजिट, मतलब पीछे वाली जो साइट होती है, वहाँ तक वो वेपर जा नहीं पाता है, क्योंकि मोस्ट ऑफ द वेपर आगे के पोर्शन में ही रेन के थ्रू नीचे आ जाता है. तो उसकी वजह से जो लीवर्ड साइड होता है, मतलब पीछे पीछे का एरिया होता है माउंटेन का, वहाँ पे रेन कम होता है और उसकी वजह से ड्रॉट कंडीशन आ जाती है. उसके बाद है ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज़। सो ह्यूमन एक्टिविटी कैन डायरेक्टली ट्रिगर द एक्सकल्परेटेड द फैक्टर्स सच एज अ डीफॉरेस्टेशन फॉर एग्रीकल्चर, एक्सेसिव इरीगेशन, ओवर फार्मिंग, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग एट्सेट्रा। सो ये सारी जो ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज़ है उसकी वजह से भी ड्रॉट कंडीशन अकर होती है। एडवर्सली अफेक्ट द एबिलिटी ऑफ अ लैंड टू कैप्चर एंड होल्ड मॉइस्चर, उसकी वजह से जो लैंड की एबिलिटी होती है मॉइस्चर होल्ड करने की वो भी अफेक्ट होती है। एंड एक्टिविटीज़ रिजल्टिंग इन अ ग्लोबल क्लाइमेट चेंज आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू ट्रिगर दिस प्रॉब्लम्स। एंड द लास्ट वन इज़ अ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग। सो ओवरऑल ग्लोबल वार्मिंग विल रिजल्ट इन इंक्रीज ऑफ वर्ल्ड रेनफॉल अलॉन्ग विद द ड्रॉट इन सम एरियाज एंड फ्लडिंग एंड एरोजन इन अदर एरियाज। सो ग्लोबल वार्मिंग की वजह से ड्रॉट आ सकता है, वो डिपेंड्स करता है अलग अलग प्रॉब्लम पे, राइट। सो अगर हम लोग इंडिया की बात करें तो वहाँ पे बहुत सारे कॉमन कॉजेज है ड्रॉट्स के लिए। तो जैसे कि मेट्रोलॉजिकल कॉजेज है, तो उसमें अगर हम लोग देखें तो इनएडिक्वेट मॉनसून रेनफॉल होता है, हाई टेम्परेचर होता है यहाँ पे, हाई विंड वेलोसिटी है जिसकी वजह से रेट ऑफ इवेपोरेशन हाई हो जाता है, प्री मॉनसून रेन्स होते हैं कभी कभी, सो इट रिड्यूस एंड टेम्परेचर एंड लो प्रेशर डज नॉट गेट डेवलप्ड ब्रिंग मॉनसून रेन, राइट। अगर हम लोग देखिए वाटर रिसोर्स कॉजेज के बारे में, तो उसके अंदर हम लोग देख सकते हैं कि इनएडिक्वेट वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी है, ठीक है, अलग अलग जगह पे अलग अलग वाटर की अवेलेबिलिटी है इंडिया में, हायर वाटर लॉस होते हैं सीपेज एंड पर्कुलेशन की वजह से, हाई वाटर लॉस होते हैं डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन में, ठीक है, एंड ओवर एक्सप्लोरिनेशन ऑफ सरफेस एंड ग्राउंड वाटर होता है। अगर हम लोग एग्रीकल्चर की बात करें तो क्रॉप डैमेज ड्यू टू रेन एंड फ्लडिंग होता है, ओवर इरीगेशन होता है बाय ट्रेडिशनल मैथड ऑफ फ्लडिंग, राइट, तो उसकी वजह से भी ड्रॉट की कंडीशन आ सकती है। एंड अगर हम लोग पॉपुलेशन की बात करें यहाँ पे, तो यहाँ पे राइज इन अ कंसप्टिव यूज़ ऑफ वाटर बाय ह्यूमन एंड एनिमल्स, ओवर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ वाटर इन अर्बन एरियाज, अर्बन एरियाज में पानी का यूज़ थोड़ा ज़्यादा होता है, वेस्टेज ऑफ वाटर इन अ स्लम एरियाज, राइट। तो ये सारे कॉजेज थे अगर हम लोग ड्रॉट की बात करें। तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो एक अर्थ है और उसके ऊपर एक ओजोन लेयर होता है। जब ये ओजोन लेयर कहीं से अफेक्ट होता है, जैसे कि यहाँ पे होल आ गया है, ठीक है, तो ऐसी कंडीशन में क्या होता है, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, और दिस हैज़ इंक्रीज्ड एवरेज टेम्परेचर एंड कॉज क्लाइमेट चेंजेस एंड द अर्थ एटमोसफियर एंड ऑल्सो कॉजेज अ ड्रॉट, राइट, उसकी वजह से ड्रॉट कंडीशन आती है। अब हम लोग बात करेंगे टाइप्स ऑफ ड्रॉट की। सो बेसिकली देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ड्रॉट। फर्स्ट इज अ मेट्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट, सेकेंड इज अ हाइड्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट एंड द थर्ड वन इज अ एग्रीकल्चरल ड्रॉट। अगर हम लोग मेट्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट के बारे में बात करें, तो मेट्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड सोली ऑन अ बेसिस ऑफ अ डिग्री ऑफ ड्राइनेस इन अ कंप्रेशन टू सम नॉर्मल और एवरेज अमाउंट एंड ड्यूरेशन ऑफ अ ड्राई पीरियड, राइट। सो इट इज अबाउट ब्रॉट अबाउट वेन देर इज अ प्रोलॉन्ग्ड एरिया पीरियड विद द लेस एवरेज प्रेसिपिटेशन, देन वी कैन से दिस इज अ मेट्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट। सो द इंडियन मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट हैज़ क्लासिफाइड अ ड्रॉट अंडर थ्री टाइप्स, mild drought, moderate drought and severe drought. So let's start with this. So meteorological drought is generally defined by comparing the rainfall in a particular place and particular time. So this happens when the actual rainfall area is significantly less than a climatological mean of that area. So meteorological drought leads to soil moisture and always has an effect on a crop production. So basically meteorological drought usually proceeds like kind of droughts, and the intensity of and duration are key characters of this type of drought. So a year is considered to be a drought year in the case of area is affected by a moderate or a severe drought is more than 20% of that the total area of the country. अगर हम लोग नेक्स्ट बात करें हाइड्रोलॉजिकल ड्रॉट, So, hydrological drought is brought about when the water reserves available in our sources such as the aquifer, lakes, reservoirs, river fall below the statistical average. It is associated with the effects of a period of a precipitation, a shortfall on a surface, subsurface, and water supply rather than the precipitation shortfalls. So basically, hydrological drought has a four components, that is a magnitude, duration, severity, and frequency of occurrence. So basically, hydrological drought is associated with the effect of low rainfall on a water level in a reservoir, rivers, and lakes. So this type of drought notice sometimes after a meteorological drought. And hydrologically drought can change in a water level and affects the ecosystem. So hydrological drought usually are noticed as we have seen after a meteorological drought, and as a result, impact of a hydrological drought out of phase with the impact of other drought types. And also water in a hydrological system such as a reservoir, rivers, groundwater, often it is used for a multiple and completing purposes for the sequence and a quantification of impacts. Now let's talk about the agricultural drought. So agricultural drought occurs when there is not enough water available for a particular crop to grow at the particular time. This drought doesn't depends on amount of rainfall where water is usually carelessly for irrigation and other purposes. Under the circumstances, the effects of a drought become a more prolonged than it was before. So you can see in this figure, agricultural drought is typically seen after the meteorological drought, but before the hydrological drought. So agricultural drought affect the crop production or the ecology of this range. Now we will see effects of a drought. So drought produces a large number of impacts and that affect the social, environmental, and economical standard of living. Its effects are spread for beyond the physical effect of a drought itself, and water is integral to produce a good and provide a certain services. So the many effects of a drought can be listed as a economical, environmental, and social. So let's see what economical effects are drought are there. So there is a loss of a national economic growth, slowing down of economic development, damage to the crop quality, less food production, increase in a food price, increase in a importation of a flood, insect infestation, plant disease, loss from a dairy and livestock production, unavailability of a water and feed for a livestock, increase in a predation, range fires and wildlands fires, damage to the fish habitat, income loss for a farmers, unemployment from a production, loss of a recreational and tourism industry, loss of a hydroelectric power and loss of a navigations. If we see environmental effects, so there is increased in a damage to animal species, reduction to degradation of a fish, lack of a feed and drinking water, disease are there, increased predation, loss of wildlife in some areas, increased stress, damage to a plant, increase the number and the severity of fires, wind and water erosion of a soil. Now we will see social effects of a drought. So shortage of food, loss of a human life, mental and physical stress, water user conflicts, political conflicts, social unrest, public dissatisfaction with the government regarding a drought response, inequality in the distribution of a drought relief, loss of a cultural sites, reduced the quality of a life, which leads to changes in a lifestyle, increased the poverty. So these all are the social effects of a drought. Okay friends, अब हम लोग नेक्स्ट लेक्चर का नेक्स्ट टॉपिक नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में पढ़ेंगे. तब तक अगर आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम है, कोई क्वेरी है, तो आप मुझे कॉल करके पूछ सकते हो या फिर गूगल मीटिंग में पूछ सकते हो. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग.